Welcome back, trainers. So the Genesect Special Research paid event has been announced. So this is going to be kind of like the Regigigas event, in which you're going to have to pay for that ticket. And then when the time comes around, you're going to be able to participate. But this time around, we're going to have a much bigger time span. And not only that, you're going to be able to complete this by yourself and not having to go around and complete raids with other people, legendary raids at that. You're going to be able to just run through this by yourself. And not only that, the price on this Genesect Research Special Pass event is going to be a little bit more than the Regigigas, although you're going to be getting a little bit more out of it. So we're going to be going over all the details you need to know, folks. So go ahead and hit that like button if you do enjoy these videos. Share it with a friend of yours who may be interested in this and learning about the details revolving around this. All right, so Niantic does throw out a few words here that kind of, I wouldn't say are misleading, but it kind of makes it seem like you can take place in this event without having a pass, and we're going to go over that. So taking a look at the bottom there, whether or not you have a ticket, you'll be able to enjoy this weekend-long Genesect theme event. Now, right off the bat, I was thinking to myself, what is going on here when I first read this? Does that mean that everybody's going to be able to take part in this special event? You're just not going to get, you know, a lot of the exclusive items, but you will get the Genesect. No. So basically, there's going to be an event within an event. I know we've been seeing a whole lot of that lately. A little bit overwhelmed, I guess. A lot of people are, and they're just starting to get burned out with all these events. But, you know, you don't have to participate in all of this stuff here, right? So the event outside of the actual paid event for the Genesect is going to be going down March 20th at 8 a.m. until Monday, March 23rd at 10 p.m., in which you're going to have different spawns in the wild, as well as the Nincada being introduced as a shiny. You're also going to be getting times to catch Stardust and times to hatch Stardust, which is really nice, right? Anything revolving around extra Stardust is going to be more than welcome. We're also going to be getting Kabalion with its signature move, Sacred Sword, so that should be pretty interesting. We'll see how good that is going to be. We still do not have any sort of numbers on whether or not it's going to be performing really nice or not. They go on to say Professor Willow has found a particular trail of damage that appears to have been created by a single Pokemon, the kicker. The damage seems to have been caused by attacks of a wide variety of types. So what that means is we're going to be getting different types of Genesect. I'm not too sure if it's going to be at random or if we're going to get a special item enabling us to change the Genesect. We've been over this many times before. It's going to have four different forms in which it can carry a different move on each one of those, right? So taking a look at the free event that's going to be starting on March 20th until March 23rd, you're going to see increased spawns for Magnemite, Houndoom, Snorunt, as well as Nincada in the wild and in 5-kilometer eggs. Also that shiny introduction, as well as Kabalion being introduced with shiny in its signature move. I'm going to be honest with you, I'm going to go out there and do a few Kabalions, but I haven't really been going hard on the raids lately, guys. It's just, I am a bit burnt out, and keeping up with the videos and editing them and then trying to get up a second video for the day is a little exhausting. It's more time consuming, so I'm not able to go out there and do all that, as well as spend time with my son. So yeah, I'm definitely going to go out there and hopefully try to find one, because Sacred Sword, signature move, very nice. We are going to be getting the Elite TM, but then again, just because we're getting the Elite TM in the future doesn't mean I should miss out on specific special Pokemon events, they're getting a special move, because I don't necessarily want to use my Elite TM on all these different Pokemon, right? So I will have a link to all of the images down below, or at least their Twitter, so you can go ahead and follow them and also get these images yourself. So let's go ahead and start focusing on the Genesect special research here that you're going to be paying for. So we're going to see a similar thing like we did see with the Colossal Pass, and that is going to be, it's going to appear in the shop, you're going to pay for it, it's going to go into your inventory, and then when the time comes, you simply open up your game within the time period given to do this. As we've seen, we're going to have about 6 days to complete this. So plenty of time to do whatever you need to do, and you're not going to have to do it with other people. You can complete this by yourself. I know that there is a concern right now with a specific type of thing that's going around, right? And it's a bit dangerous for some people to go around in the public. I don't want to fearmonger or make it so you're scared to go outside or anything like that. You shouldn't do that, but also be mindful, you know, where you're at. Has there been reports or whatnot, right? if anything, just, you know, play by yourself, do what you have to do, but don't, you know, completely isolate yourself here, folks, okay? But at the same time, stay safe, right? Don't want to condone anything here. So it is going to be going down from March 20th at 8 a.m. until Thursday, March 26th at 10 p.m. So you will be able to purchase the ticket all the way up until the last day if you forgot, say, right? Or you're just simply busy. But I urge you to purchase that ticket beforehand if you do plan to do this. Now, let's go ahead and look at the items because that's probably going to be the most important thing. Now, different from the Colossal Pass, we did get those raid passes, 5 of them, but they were not premium. They were raid passes in which you had to continuously use them. And if you did not use them for that day or the next raid, you wouldn't collect your next raid pass because it was an orange raid pass, right? The free one. For this event, you're getting 5 premium raid passes and you'll be able to hold them. Hopefully this is not a misprint by Niantic, so let's just hope that this is true. But I think that that's what we're going to be getting because that was in the vlog, as well as 3 super incubators, 3 charge and fast TMs. That's 3 of each. All right, that's not bad, although I'm stacked on those. Honestly, I need more quick TMs. 3 incense, okay, 3 star pieces, not bad. 1 poffin, fine. 15 rare candies, I like it. And then 1 glacial lure. So random. All right, so let's take a look at the prices here. Is this worth it? Plus early access to Genesect. Genesect is going to be an EX raid boss come April. So if you're not interested in giving Niantic your money or you do not condone these kind of passes that you have to pay for, you can simply wait. As far as me endorsing this for people to go out there and purchase it, I'm not going to say do it and I'm not going to say not do it. What do I think? I personally like these things, okay? Yes, it's not great to give more money to Niantic when they're not fixing their game. I understand the concerns, but personally, this is my job and I have to be on top of all of it. Any kind of new event is exciting for me. Anything that shifts away from the norm to bring some sort of special item or Pokemon or something like that, I enjoy personally, right? So you do what you got to do, and I know everybody has their own personal opinion, and this is a bit expensive. You're also going to be encountering Pinsir, Karrablast, and here's the best part. Well, I wouldn't say the best part, but a very good thing here for a lot of people is you're going to be able to encounter Durant, which is only available in a certain part of the world for certain trainers. Now, here is another issue. People who live in the region where Durant is at, what are you going to get? You're going to get a Durant. So that's a bit of a downfall. Somebody I seen on Twitter saying something like, maybe they should have put both of the regionals in there. Depending on where you're at, you will get the opposite one that is spawning for your area, which would have been a good idea. And Niantic can still implement that. So if you're watching Niantic or anybody is hearing this, maybe tell them this idea and maybe they might implement it because that'll make some people a little bit happier. And then, of course, you're going to be able to get the Genesect. So this event is going to be $7.99, folks, $8. And in some places, it's going to be upwards towards $13. That's pretty pricey, folks. I know if you buy, you know, the special boxes, those are pretty much a little bit more than that. And for this event, to have early access as well as the items, sure. I think it's a fun idea, right? So the whole Durant idea is pretty nice. We just discussed that. I personally have one already, but I mean, I could use another one if I get a good IV one. Sure, why not? And then you're going to be able to encounter Pinsir, Scyther, Skarmory, Karrablast, Shelmet. And if we go down to the bottom here, Scyther, Skarmory, Nincada, and Shieldon after you completed the field research tasks, as well as, of course, the Genesect itself. So Genesect is going to be a bug and steel type. So it's pretty fun that they're implementing the Durant. But like we discussed, people who already have Durant in their area, it's kind of a bummer. It's kind of a little bit of a letdown, but it doesn't take away from the whole experience. So yeah, but maybe if Niantic could implement the other regionals for the other people who have that already, or at least that regional that's spawning in their area. And then if we take a look at the bottom, tickets can be purchased from when they go live until March 26th at 8 p.m. your local time. So they don't have an exact date as to when the tickets are going to go live, but you know, YouTubers are going to talk about it. You're going to get Twitter notifications. If you're not a part of Twitter, then I'll make a video and I'll be keeping you guys all posted and up to date. So let's go ahead and take a look at what I was talking about in the beginning of the video that might be appealing to people who like to PvP in the Great League or participate in Silith Arena tournaments. And that is going to be the fact that your Genesect is going to be Great League level. As you can see here, the research encounters, the minimal is going to be 1375, 100% IV is going to be 1437. And then when you go into the raids, 100% is going to be 1916, and then the lowest one is going to be 1833, and then you see the weather boost down there. So that's a bit of a plus if you're trying to use this in the Great League. Personally, this is going to be a good Pokemon to actually max out too. A bit pricey, you're going to have to put those rare candies in there because you're only going to be able to encounter that one or and when you go to the EX raid. So there you go. And did I mention you're going to be able to get a hat and bag, folks? Okay, that's a lot of money. I got to be honest here. So my opinion, folks, what is my final verdict here? It's a little bit biased because, like I mentioned, I do this for a living. So any sort of event like this is pretty exciting. I'm going to admit, though, the price is a bit expensive. It is a bit expensive, but you have to look at all other games, you know, sort of events that you have to pay for or add-ons. I mean, they're kind of the same price. You're getting something fun to do. It is encouraging you to go out of your comfort zone probably nowadays because of the whole virus that's going around. But otherwise, I think that this is fun. It is a bit expensive though, and they should probably twerk a few things regarding the Durant for people in those specific areas. Anyways, if you did enjoy this video, please give it a big thumbs up, trainers. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll be catching you all next time. And one more thing that I forgot to mention, trainers, before I let you go, is the fact that you're not going to be able to use Pokecoins. Okay.